Hello again, everybody, and welcome to our weekly interview on WWE.com. It is my honor and privilege this week to welcome two of the all-time greats to the forum, Hall of Famer Arn Anderson and the legendary Michael P.S. Hayes.
I like how you just looked at him and said Hall of Famer, and then you just threw it to me. Yeah, that's great. I'm happy for you.
One day. Nonetheless,
it's accurate.
I want to talk about...
Well-deserved, too.
Thank you, Michael.
Triple H and Sting
right
at WrestleMania. And I want to start with you, Arn. You were there in WCW in its heyday. Sting was the face, the icon, the franchise of WCW. What was so special about Sting?
Well, number one, I think Sting signed the very first contract with WCW when that company was purchased. And I would dare say he was probably on contract well after it went out of business, a couple of years into WWE buying the company. That being on the business end, that's how they looked at Sting. He was a very valuable commodity. But Sting started, grew as a person, grew as a human being, grew as a performer. In every way imaginable, Sting grew into who he is today with WCW because he's the one guy that was walking in the door first and the last guy to walk out.
With that being said, Michael.
Well, can I just add to that?
Course.
Because I actually met Sting before he got to WCW, back in the UWF days. And this guy had a drive from the get-go. He had a desire to get to the top, and he was going to do it in his own way, which was unique. Now, WCW back in the day, because I've had a lot of experience there, was kind of a good old boys network. You know what I mean? And if you weren't in with the certain crowd, then you may not get the best opportunities to break through the glass ceiling. Sting did that when he went 45 minutes with the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Once he got that attention, he also got that good old boy network to look and see that there was something fresh, something new, something exciting. I don't know if you agree with that.
Yeah, I do. And it was a hard 45 minutes.
Oh, my God.
It wasn't just Flair leading him through it.
No.
It was a hard-fought 45 minutes.
You know, Michael, Arn said something about Sting, that he never left. He was the first to sign and the last to leave. A parallel can be drawn with Triple H, who he meets at WrestleMania, because Triple H never left. All his friends left, or most of them, but he stuck through it here in the Monday Night War. There's something to be said for that.
Well, there is something to be said for that. And, you know, when you, first of all, let's just call it what it is. This is a match we never thought we would see, and we're never going to see it again. You know, and in some form or fashion, it does represent the last battalions, if you will, of the WCW, WWE Monday Night War. But when you talk about Triple H, you talk about the game, there's one other thing you got to talk about. This is a man that is so experienced at WrestleMania. Sting has never, ever competed at WrestleMania. That is big advantage, Triple H. Both these guys, they kind of come from the same cut of cloth when it comes to loyalty, when it comes to how they feel about their brand. And both guys are going to go in there, in my opinion, they're both going to be prepared. But Sting has never had the experience of being at WrestleMania.
You know, Arn, we haven't heard anything from Sting. But Triple H...
Probably because he didn't want to talk to you.
Well, probably, and nobody does, but anyhow, Triple H seems to think that if you're a WWE fan, that there is no way that you should root for Sting in this match at WrestleMania because Sting was part of the company, like you were, WCW, that tried to put us at WWE out of business. Do you buy that argument?
Well, I don't buy the fact that the talent pool with WCW tried to put the talent pool of WWE out of business. I don't agree with that. That was something between management that had their chest blown out, making a stupid statement.
Eric Bischoff.
Well, I'm going to put Vince McMahon out of business in 30 days. I almost fell out of my chair backwards. I'm not some goofball, you know. You can't dump a bucket of water down my back and tell me it's raining. You know, that's just me, you know. So, I mean, we were at war, but it was a healthy war because guess who the recipients of all the glitz and gold and glamour were? The fans. You know, they were the winners.
But, Michael, you were here.
Oh, I was.
And, you know, we were in the same boat. We didn't know if we were going to have a job the next day. It was the Monday Night War. So does Hunter have an argument where if you're a WWE fan, you should not root for Sting in this match?
I just don't think you can dictate to the audience. You know, I could see where that feeling can be coming from deep inside. I think, too, you got to know the game is the game. And he's going to play a lot of mind games with Sting. He's going to try to check him out. He's going to test him out. He's been doing that already. But if you're a fan of this genre, if you're a fan of this industry, you're just going to be a fan of this match. I mean, can you really say who you were pulling for in the Undertaker Shawn Michaels match? It was just too good. And it's just like any good, you know, sporting competition, you get caught up in a good game. No pun intended. This is going to be a great game. This is going to be a chess match. And I will dare say that some WWE fans that have never heard of Sting will be won over by Sting, by his presence, by his aura.
So finally, I'm going to ask both of you guys and put you on the spot. Start with you, Michael. What happens at WrestleMania between Sting and Triple H?
It's going to come down to who makes the fewest mistakes. You know, you got to keep in mind that why did Sting come back? This guy's not stupid, okay? We know how calculating the game is, but Sting, he didn't come back to lose. He didn't come back just to be at WrestleMania. He didn't go pick out the baddest guy. He's got a plan. He's going to try to execute it. Whether he does or not, if you're asking me my opinion, I say I don't think so.
Let me ask you this. Do you think Sting and Triple H are not alike in a lot of ways? Think about it this way. Anti-establishment, Sting.
Yep.
Buck the system.
Yep.
Sting. Baseball bat on the nose of the authority. So don't think it's WCW or the shadows of what used to be against WWE. That's not what this fight's about. If I was Triple H, I wouldn't think that many fans were happy with what he's been doing with this company. Abuse of power stretches across this entire world. Sting's a guy that has the guts to step up and do something about it.
Either way, it's a match like Michael said before, we've never seen before, and we're never going to see again.
Right.
You know why most fights end very early? Because you just don't know. Nerves get you, and you hesitate.
And that's what it is. It's going to revolve around who makes the fewest mistakes. And who either one of these guys is capable, one mistake putting you away.
And if one hesitates, it may be an early victory.
Guys, thank you for joining us. And we want to remind everyone on WWE.com that this coming Monday, we have a much more in-depth look at the man called Sting. We'll hear some more from Arn Anderson and from Michael PSAs and other legends who have followed the career of Sting. That comes up on Monday. Thank you for joining us.